As designers, we're always looking for new ways to speed up our workflows. And when I saw repeat grids, I knew that this was going to be one of those features. If you spend any time working on repeated elements such as photo galleries, menus, or contact lists, you're definitely going to want to check this out. Let's take a look. On this project, I may want to design out a gallery of all the lovely photos in this user's library, including location information. I already have one of the cards set up, which contains a simple rectangle, text, and a location icon. Either in the Layers panel or by creating a selection on the canvas, I'll go ahead and select all the layers that make up this card. Now, to create the repeat grid, I can either use the Command or Control R shortcut or press the Repeat Grid button over to the right. You'll now notice two handles, one to the right and one at the bottom. These will allow me to repeat this entry horizontally, vertically, or both, and I can create as many as I need. In addition to the handles, the padding between the entries can easily be adjusted by hovering in between them and dragging on the pink area. Perfect. Now the real fun begins. With the cards now set up, we need some content. Here's a folder containing all the images I want included, and I could go ahead and drag each image into each rectangle, but no one's about that life. When using repeat grids, all of your images can be dragged directly onto the grid, and it'll populate the boxes automatically, no matter how many you're working with. What's just as neat is you can do the same thing for text. Here I have a plain text document with a bunch of city names. And just like with the images, I can drag this file onto any of the text layers and Adobe XD does the rest. You know, now that I'm looking at the design, I may want to make a few changes. For text layers, you can edit those on a one-off basis. Let me quickly change the name of the city so that it matches the photo. For layout changes, you thankfully don't need to update each individual entry. Changing one changes them all. The same applies if you need to add in additional objects to your grid. Over in my Assets panel, I have this component which I'd like to include. With any of the entries selected, I can simply drag in the object and it'll automatically add to the entire grid. And when I reposition it, they all stay in sync. But since this object is a component, and components can be overridden, I'm able to jump into its layers and make changes to just this individual card within the repeat grid. And that's how you can use repeat grids to drastically improve your workflows.